Hi there, welcome to Create with Copper. Today I want to show you how to make these air-chased copper earrings. The materials I'm using for this is 0.6mm thick copper sheet, and this piece is about 5cm by 6cm, and some earring findings. And the tools I'm using are dapping punches, a hammer, a vise, a jeweller's torch and soldering block, some flat nose pliers, a rawhide mallet, a jeweller's saw and bench peg, a hole punch or drill, files and polishing tools, and some liver of sulphur. I've already annealed the piece of copper, so now I just want to bend it gently around into a curve. You can use any of your pliers just to help with this. And I want those edges to meet and be able to fit into the vise, so I can just bend those back a little bit so that they're touching. And the idea is to have as large an area in the middle, the air that you're chasing onto. Then I can secure the copper into the vise. I'm going to take a fairly large punch and make dents alternately either side of the copper. Now the reason for working here first is to try to prevent the copper just kind of collapsing over and ending up with two sharp edges where the vise is holding it. And once I've gone in with a large dapping punch, I can then reduce that punch down a bit and go in on the same dents. And I can just keep reducing the punches until I'm happy that those dents will hold the copper quite well. And then I can start punching some dents a little further up the copper. And do the same the other side. And then you can start along the top of the copper. Now it's beginning to get quite difficult to make a dent in the copper because it's work hardened through the punches that I've already done. So I think this is ready to anneal again to soften it back up again before I continue. So I'm just going to heat the piece of copper with the torch until it reaches a glowing pink colour. Then I know it's annealed and it will be soft enough to continue hammering. I want to turn the piece over just to make sure it's heated evenly both sides. And I hope you can see the pink colour, it's just glowing. So now I can just quench the piece in my water just to cool it down again, and then we're ready to continue hammering. So we're back at the vise and ready to start going again. And hopefully you'll see now the copper's annealed, it's an awful lot easier to make those dents in it. Now I'm just going to continue making these dents with some of the larger punches and then reducing down to some of the smaller ones. And I'll come back and show you how it's going. So I've worked on deepening and widening those dents and annealed as necessary. And now I want to start sharpening up some of the edges. So I'll take one of the smaller punches and just go in at a bit more of a sideways angle along those walls. I'll continue to do that with reducing sizes of the punches. So I've made my way down to the smallest of the dapping punches. I'm quite happy with the shapes that I've made and the pinch of those walls. And this punch is making a really nice tight curve at the bottom. What you might find, it puts a little bit of a groove in the base of those areas. So if you take the next punch up and just go over it again, just smooth that out a bit. And now I think I'm about ready to open this up. But before I try opening it, I'm going to anneal it once more. So I've annealed the copper and I'm now ready to open this up. Now it might be clamped quite tightly at this point. So if you just use an awl or a solder pick just to get into the gaps, can just kind of start prising it open just to make enough space for some pliers to fit into it. You can then take your pliers and ease it open. And if you've got a couple of pairs of pliers, you might be able to use them to pull it apart. But just work steadily and gently just until you can get it flat. You might find some of the creases are a little bit kind of bent over, but you can just use your pliers to ease those around to flatten out the edges as well. Now that's the sheet fairly flattened out, but as you can see, the sides of where I've air chased it aren't quite as tight as inside. So I'm just going to tighten those up a bit by using my block. Because I'm not using the vise anymore, I have to just tape the piece down. Then I'm just going to go in with the dapping punches again and tighten up those sides. And I think that's pretty much got it how I want it. So I'm now ready to flatten it out fully with the rawhide mallet. But before I do that, I'm going to anneal it one last time. So I've annealed the copper, and because that's the last time I'll be annealing it, I've cleaned it up in the pickle as well. So I'm now just going to take my rawhide mallet and gently flatten the whole piece out a bit more. And now I've got my finished air chased sheet, and I could make anything out of it, but in this case I'll start working out how I'm shaping up and finishing the earrings. So now I've got my sheet, I can decide which parts of it I want to use for the earrings. I'm not so happy about the left hand side, and what I actually want in terms of earrings, I think, from this is two rectangles with rounded corners. So looking at the design that I've got on here, I think the centre line separating the two earrings will be about here. So I'm just going to sketch a line out and then I can decide the width I want for the earrings. I think will be around about here and then about the same over the other side. And then we can just check and see if we like the design that's going to be on the two earrings and then mark those lines on properly. Making sure the width is even, the sides are parallel, and deciding what length we want the rectangles. And then just use my jeweller's saw to cut out those shapes and make sure I've rounded off the corners. now need to file the edges, both to make them straight and to remove any burrs. If you have one, a large flat file's quite handy for this, but your smaller needle files will work too. And you might find where the creases are that you need a small rounded file to get in there. Whilst you're filing, check the two rectangles against each other to make sure they're even and make any adjustments as necessary. I want to make two holes in the top for the earrings to hang from the findings, so I'm just going to mark where I want the hole to be. And I'm going to use my drill, so I just want to use the centre punch to make sure it's in an accurate spot, and then drill those holes. Then I just want to polish up the pieces, patina them with some liver of sulphur, and then I can attach the fishhook earring findings. To complete my air chased earrings. Hope you enjoyed the video. If so, please press the like button below. Don't forget you can subscribe to my channel and head over to my website for more hints, tips and projects. See you soon.